Muchukunda, accommodating the interruption of Parikshit for knowing who the person that was sleeping in the cave was, Sage Shuka continued his narration. The noble person that was sleeping in the cave was one king called Muchukunda, a descendant of the Ikshvagu, Sri Rama's dynasty. He had left his kingdom to fight for the gods against the demons. Having served the gods successfully, he was about to return to the earth. The gods asked him to receive a boon. He asked for liberation, moksha. The gods said that they had no power to grant liberation and asked him to choose some other. They also told him that all his relatives and his kingdom on the earth were gone due to lapse of time while he was engaged in heaven. So he asked them to give him long sleep and they granted it. He came to the earth and was having his hard-earned sleep. Disturbed by Kala Yavana, he got angry, and by his angry look, Kala Yavana was burned to ashes. Meanwhile, Sri Krishna, having completed his action in inaction, came forward to grace Muchukunda, whose time was ripe. Muchukunda looked at the new person and was stunned at his grandeur and majesty, grace and compassion. He begged to be enlightened on the identity of the stranger. Sri Krishna told him that he was the Supreme, born at the request of Brahma and Mother Earth to destroy the wicked and protect the good. So for Kamsa, who was no other than Kalanemi, reborn, had been destroyed. The one that was burnt in his presence was the wicked king Kala Yavana. The Lord further said, "You have been a great devotee of mine for long. I would like to grant you some boon. You may ask." Muchukunda began to praise the Lord. "You protect your devotees from the influence of your Maya, which is very difficult to transcend. The ordinary soul or jiva, out of the merits of his previous births, gets a human form. He is deceived by your Maya, so he does not think of seeking your feet, but is attracted by wife, children, wealth, kingdom, might and power. He gets very fond of his body and thus wastes his precious life. Being the great time factor, you put an end to his life according to his destiny. The body becomes a prey to many insects and worms. Knowing this, some great men and emperors have left off their pleasures and performed tapas, but their aim even there was towards material gains. When your grace flows on such men, they get relieved of all their bonds. They seek the company of saints, develop devotion towards you, and finally they are liberated. So I feel that satsang is a great achievement. I therefore pray for nothing more than other than your service. That is the only way for liberation. My pursuits after desires and fruits have been great. Their vasanas have not left me. I am not able to control my six senses. I am not able to obtain peace. I beseech you for protection." Accordingly, the Lord blessed Muchukunda and told him that he would have one more birth as a Brahmin and then finally reach him. So he asked him to go and rule over his kingdom for the rest of his lifetime. Muchukunda went round Sri Krishna, prostrated to him, and left for Badrikashrama to perform tapas and to worship the Lord there. Sri Krishna returned to Mathura and destroyed the whole army of Kala Yavana, which was still waiting, expecting the return of their king, and so was continuing the siege of Mathura. Then Sri Krishna and Balarama began to complete the transfer of all the wealth and materials from Mathura to Dwaraka. As this was going on, Jarasandha again besieged Mathura with 23 battalions. In bright daylight, Sri Krishna and Balarama came out of the city unarmed and barefooted and began to run fast. Jarasandha saw this strange action of theirs and followed them. The brothers ran and ran, and at last they reached the mountain called Parvarshanagiri and climbed over it. It was a very high mountain and gave protection from sun and rain to many thousands of jivas. Seeing the brothers climb the step mountain, Jarasandha directed his men to collect fuel round the mountain and set fire to the mountain, expecting thereby to burn Sri Krishna and Balarama alive. As he was engaged in this foolish and futile effort, Sri Krishna and Balarama jumped off the mountain on the other side without anybody noticing them and reached Dwaraka. Jarasandha waited there till a major portion of the mountain was on fire, decided that the brothers must have been burned to death, and returned to his country with his army and with an air of triumph.